Hey, Eparry, you left some comments on my video here. I just want to touch on them really quickly. The video that I did for you and Sofiarune. You say, "Of course, I don't think you should give up your home, but Jesus seems to think that you should. I doubt he gave it to you any more than he gave me the property I earned through hard work and careful planning of my resources." He also says, "Clearly, I tell you the truth. I.e., watch my lips and then lead by example. You said we are to live by Christ, like Christ. Does that not mean that he considers any possessions and family and friends a lack of focus on him?" No, that's not what that means, and I'm going to get to that. You also said, "Michelle, I'm not judging. I don't think you should live a monastic life, but then I think it's all pure nonsense anyway." There is an inconsistency in your reply in which you say we are to live like Christ, but then go on to say that actually you don't have to. That's left up to interpretation. I'm going to touch on that as well. All I'm saying is that the two rules may not be enough, and you may have to obey his other instructions too. Problem is, that is difficult to know, isn't it? Which might make it difficult for anybody other than devout monks and nuns to get in. If the two rules were not enough, then it wouldn't say that in the Bible. And it says, when those two rules are laid out, it says specifically that this is all you need. If it wasn't all you need, if you had to resort to Old Testament rituals and practices, then it would say that. But the Bible says this is all you need to remember. If you forget anything I've said, anything I've taught you, and we all hear people use that line, right? This is what he was saying. If you forget everything else, remember these two rules. Okay? So here's my response to the comments that you left. If I am wrong, then God will be my judge on that. So I just want to say that first. So to say that we are to live as Christ, it is talking about his words, his actions, not his physical life. Should we all be carpenters too then, as Christ was? Building houses for who then? If we all gave up our possessions, there would be no need for houses or furniture or anything else that they made with wood or whatever back then, and Christ's work would have all been in vain. The work that he did as a carpenter before he started his ministry would have all been in vain, which I don't think it was. I don't think God makes mistakes. Christ was the only person alive without sin. Would he have this position as a carpenter to teach us something contradictory, that we shouldn't have these things at all? At all? Just because he didn't does not mean that he's saying that we can't have those things, because otherwise his whole work as a carpenter is wiped out as useless, and that makes no sense to me at all. So yes, God gives us our homes, whether it is through hard work or through prayer and what you would call chance or careful planning of your resources. God has given me many things that I can only give him credit for. I don't expect you to understand this, though. Without faith in God, it would seem like nonsense to you, wouldn't it? You say that personal possessions might take away our focus, and as I have said that before, that is true, it is possible. But what does that mean? It means that when we place more value on our possessions than on the word of God says, that is when it takes away our focus. Also, when we fail to see that what we have as possessions, that everything comes from God, and we do not thank him for it, and we do not recognize that, that takes away our focus away from the fact that indeed God is the giver and supplier of all our needs. We tend not to trust him so much and to rely on him because we think that we don't need him. We can get these things on our own, such as you say you got, quote, "the property I earned through hard work and careful planning of my resources," end of quote. Seems there is absolutely no need of any God in your life, right? That's what he was talking about. Living like Christ. Okay? Acting the way he acted. The sacrifices he made. the love that he had for people, regardless of who they were and where they came from and what they had done in their lives, that was the focus of living like Christ. It's ridiculous to think that to live like Christ would mean that we have to give everything up. Okay? For some people, that might be necessary. God might direct some people. Okay? But along with possessions, you also mentioned family and friends. And I don't understand where you're coming from with that, because when you're talking about family, I mean, I can understand how it relates to possessions and the fact that, I mean, like I said, if it takes away your focus from God, if we don't recognize where our family and our friends come from, which is from God, like our possessions, then it's really not worth it to have them. God gives us certain people in our lives for a reason. He gives us our family and our friends to help us and to teach us and to show us himself. We need to recognize that. That's pretty much all there is to say about that. So I don't know, I'm sure you would have plenty more to say about this, so I will look forward to hearing what you have to say. All right, take care.